30-minute game. So, as usual, just pushing through here. It's as usual because we're used to this sort of pattern. And just capture. And no matter what, we just take the knight if it doesn't take the knight. Keep it as simple as possible. Yep, so it doesn't take the knight, so we take the knight. Okay, the queen's out. They're attacking this pawn, so we simply defend by bringing the queen here. So we simply take the queen off the board and support the pawn. Castle. And support the pawn. Just attack the bishop. Got the support of the pawn and the rook. Just capture back. In this situation here, now I'm going to take a moment to think. If we do move, then the knight moves and then the rook is on the pawn. Are we looking to rebalance and bring the bishop here? Do we have that time? Because if we do move, and if the knight rebalances, we can't go there because the bishop can take it back. It can go there, bishop takes, and this bishop takes. I'm going to go with this. It's the longest moment we've taken in the game. So we'll be targeting this pawn because it's got no protection. The knight's not going back there because it can't go there. It can't physically. It can go here. Or it can go there. I don't think it'll waste its time going here because it'll get captured. So it may be looking for the exchange. But we can just bring the bishop here just to protect. Okay, that's the knight doesn't have any protection. It's aiming towards here with his. I think I like this position better. I don't think it's going to stay there for long because the rook will attack it, but let's go here for now. So it is defending the pawn for a brief moment. So maybe his knight's coming here, so that's why the bishop is protecting this area, but knight's also covering this area. So he wants to get rid of our knight. Let's go here and then let's trap his bishop. I can feel a Fischer Spassky coming on. Famous Bobby Fischer move. But we can't rush to go and get it because our knight is under a bit of a problem. So we can't attack here because he's got... The knight can take... Then they take it, so we're down a few. So, let's have a look at the situation. Shall we just move the pawn up now? Let's move the pawn up. A bit frantic with the moves now, so everything's happening on this side. I was interested in bringing the knight here, attacking their knight, but I think they're going to jump here, attacking this pawn and that pawn. So if we push this, looking backwards again at the moves, so it's gonna try and use his power base because he's got more pawns on this side. Yeah, like I said. So it does give us time to jump here now because his knight can't go to this side because the pawn will take him. But he still does have a lot of weight and the rook is eyeing each other up as well. So it's all gonna kick off now. So, well, I'm not actually going to take with the bishop. I thought I was, but I feel like the bishop is doing some sort of supporting work here. If we take here and then that pawn supporting, we're never really going to get this pawn up, are we? Because he's always going to have his rook here, but not really because we're going to actually take his rook off the board. For a brief moment, we might be okay. We might be able to sting his bishop. Let's go with that. Don't know how much tempo that is though, is it? Because we'll get one move out of it, but then he can move. But the rook will still be here. If it works out, he might take our rook. But I think the interest is using the advantage of these pawns to try and dishevel here. So he wants to bring his pawns back into line. Does that sometimes it disadvantages them, you know, when they do bring them back into line. Smaller piece attacking a higher piece. The bishop's going to be in the center. Let's go here. Let's attack the bishop. Ships move back. This pawn is still under attack. Can defend it with this. So we'll do that. Maybe get the king up here, attack their bishop. So if we take, still get the king up here. Let's just take it. But can come for this pawn actually.